I think I'm ready. Got the lighting fixed and everything. Hi, how are you? Hi, hello. This is about ego. My ego. Your ego. Did you know that you probably don't have an ego? Me neither. No, seriously. You don't have one. You are one. No, really. Really. Me too. I want to explain this in a whole new fucking way, what the fucking ego is, right? I think, personally, as I think, therefore I am an ego. You see? True spirit, the true essence that you truly are, perceives and knows. No thinking required. I know. Think about it. Your thinking defines you and me as ego. Now, the reason I'm talking like this, kind of like I kind of got an angry kind of thing going here, is because I believe that on this fucking planet, the main game is mind fucking spirit. That's what it's about. Now, the way you mind fuck spirit, the true essence that we are, is one, you get them caught up and engaged in a mind that you can fuck them with. Okay? You can't fuck spirit if spirit is not the mind, or engaged so steeped in mind that they don't know what the fuck is going on, right? They're confused. So when spirit stops knowing, they have to start thinking. So, whatever the bad boys can do to get you and I, the true essence, the true spirit that we are, not our ego selves, whatever they can do to keep us engaged in thinking about it, thinking processes, then they've got us, and now they're just reeling us in. So what this game is about on planet Earth is disinformation, denying us the truth, or giving us some truth as we seek truth, we know truth, and then we'll get something else that appears to be just as true, except it's contradictory. And so now we got to think about it, and we stop knowing, and we start thinking. You see? So one of the big things on that's going down on planet Earth has to do with the very words we use, terminology, names of things, like the mind. What is the mind? What is consciousness? What is a dream? What is real? What is reality? What does ascension really mean? See, these words are concepts and conceptualize, mean conceive. Spirit conceives things. Spirit makes things, creates things with consciousness and knowing and decisions and intentions. Follow through. Now, spirit can enjoy the experience of life by observing it. Perceiving it, feeling it, touching it, tasting it, smelling it. Perception and knowing. Yeah, see the motherfucker? It quacks like a duck. It looks like a fucking duck. It goes whack, 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 whack. And it flies like a fucking duck. If you fry it a little bitch, it tastes like a goddamn duck. What is it? Is it reality or is it a fucking lucid dream? Who gives a flying fuck? It's a duck. If it's perceived as a duck and you get that it's a duck and you eat the duck and it was, good dinner. Duck, okay? Now, if somebody walks along, no, that was just a lucid dream. A what? Yeah, that was a false awakening. A what? Yeah, wake up, bitch. And you go, what? You're getting confused all of a sudden. I thought I was eating a duck. I thought I was in this plane of existence having a real life and somebody tells me it's a fucking illusion. It's a dream. Well, is it a dream or is it real? Exactly. It doesn't matter, these labels. What spirit does is perceive and experience. When we get all these fucking labels thrown at us, we are taught what a dream is. We learn when we're little kids. I had a bad dream. You wake up and somebody finally, when you're 3 or 4 or 5 years old, somewhere in there, you realize that when the body is asleep and you're not, and you're running around riding a horse, you wake up in the morning and you say, "Mommy, I was riding a horse." Mommy says, "Oh, you were dreaming. It's called a dream, dear." And you go, "Okay." And so now everything you do when your body sleeps and you're awake and you're doing something in another world, it's a dream. Then later you find out that dreams are spun by the mind. What's the mind? Somebody fucking tells you what the mind is and you go, "Oh, okay." And somebody else tells you something different and you go, "Ooh, let me think about that." So you come up with a refined definition of mind, your mind, by virtue of what we are taught. But there's a part of us as spirit that gets into the game here and goes, "Look, let me see what the mind is." And you see things and you know by virtue of seeing it or perceiving it, feeling it, touching it, tasting it, sensing it in some way. That gives us our knowingness. That's what spirit does. So, there's that. But getting into the mind and thinking about it, that's a process that spirit does. Now, if spirit observes its own thinking, you have spirit observing the thinking. And there's a separation, or at least a distinction, between spirit and his thinking. When he observes, when he thinks about Gloria, "Oh, Gloria, my first girlfriend, Gloria," and he has a feeling about that, he yearns for Gloria, or now he hates the bitch, doesn't matter, he thinks something, it triggers feelings. If we, as spirit, are so engaged in the experience of the thinking and the feeling, and the "I want Gloria back, I need Gloria," we fall into this mind thing. We become, in spirit, the mind. In essence, spirit consciousness is all that is, you see. And there is no self, really, ego. There is no self. There is just that which is perceived. That's nothing creating and perceiving everything else. So in fact, the consciousness, like I'm looking in my camera and the walls and the windows and stuff, desk, that's what I am conscious of. That means I, ego self, is conscious of the stuff. Well, the stuff is the consciousness of it all. And in fact, if you look at it from a dream place, it's created with consciousness. And is the consciousness is the thing. It's okay. Now, here's the deal, and then maybe we'll wrap this up. These words, like the word ego and ego mind and dream and reality, they're fucking with the knowingness of spirit. Spirit observes and knows. But we get taught things, and so now we have to start thinking and processing and figuring it out by virtue of what we were told. Okay? So as we practice being here now, not thinking, just observing, looking, perceiving, we get in touch with our true essence, the observer. The nothing that observes the everything. No thinking. When we start thinking, we're actually focusing on and becoming the thinking. When we focus on the outer experience, the walls, the trees, the sky, we become that. Because there's no self. We become that which we focus on. So if we focus on the me, I want scrambled eggs for breakfast. I want that. I don't like flapjacks. I don't like syrup. I like health food. Me. We become what we focus on. And I don't mean like consciously focus on. We become what our attention is engaged upon. So, I want to explain, ego self, want to kind of come up with a new word or a new label for it, just for now, because there's no shaking this term, ego. It's been around a long time, and it's going to stick around. I'm pretty damn sure about that. But I want to give you a new way to look at it. And it goes like this. Basically, for spirit, consciousness, in order for it to communicate and experience life with others in an environment, whether it's physical environment, astral, causal planes, etheric, alternate realities, parallel universes, doesn't matter what or where, dream world, illusion, doesn't matter, mental world, memory and visualization world, doesn't fucking matter what you call it. In order for spirit, the consciousness that you are, in order for you and I to play a game in a life, in a universe, we have to assume a point to view it or perceive it. We'll just call that for now a reference point. A point of reference where you can have your perception point so you can look, you know, to... That's to that, you know, that's to the right of you, that's to the left of you, that's to the left of you, that's to the right of you, whatever the camera angle is on this thing. But that's above me and that's below me, okay? So you have to have a reference point. And once you have a reference point, once spirit, the consciousness, knowing, perception, the perceiving, the all that is, picks up or decides upon and knows a point from which to view, bada boom, we've got reference point. We've got a place to look at stuff. Okay, now, what stuff? Well, spirit, with this reference point, can create things to look at with thought. Just boom, I don't know, another person, another being, another me over here, boing, boom, and you perceive it maybe not physically because there's nothing to see that way, but as spirit continues to create universe upon universe of grosser and grosser density, we get finally, ultimately, down to here, we're in third density, which the things we have created, we are now creating subconsciously without our own personal reference points, conscious knowledge of how we're doing it. We go, God created it. Yeah, the creator of all that is created it. The creator of all that is created the point of view from which you are looking. And the idea of self that created was created by that same creation. You are that. You have become the creation that you've created. But it was before you were you. You were the knowingness and the perception and the creation of all that is, that is perceivable, conceivable. Okay. So, now, next way to look at this is... And this is what inspired me. Hey, I gotta go do a video, motherfucker. I gotta excuse me. The wife's we're talking this morning, and I gotta. Hey, I gotta go do a fucking video. Quick. I'm gonna talk about the ego. I'm an expert on ego. Yeah, I've been an ego for thousands of years. Anyway, here's the deal. Think of a computer game. And you got the Metal Gear, you know, the big giant robot things, and a person gets inside the big giant robot, and he's got all his equipment, he's got his computer, and he's got his monitors and sensors, and he's got his buttons for rockets, launchers, and flamethrowers and shit like that. Kind of think Transformers, kind of like Transformers, but you got a guy in there, you know. No, don't think Transformers. Think that Metal Gear. You know, fighting robot, giant fighting robot things. Think of it just like that. Your giant, the giant robot is your physical body, the big giant robot thing. You, the spirit, the consciousness. My camera's rocking back and forth. Look at that. I wonder how long it's been doing that. Bitch. Can you see the rocking back and forth thing? I do. Look here, look at the fucking thing. Hey, I'm making a movie here. Look it up. Okay. Alright. Steady. Oh, okay. It's looking good. Yeah, it's going. Every time I touch it, you go. Anyway, okay. So, the spirit that you are enters into the big giant robot body. Okay? Now, in the computer game where you got your big giant robot body, you're in there and you're sitting in a nice little chair, you're all comfy, and you've got monitors, you've got computers, you've got computer programs, you got things going on automatic, you got a lot of automatic shit going. You got gyros to keep the balance, and you've got all kinds of sensors out there so that you can get this information in. And in spirit, you're the driver. You make the decisions. Your intention is what you employ or use to control your robot so you can go to fucking war or play the game of life in your big giant robot. It's body, big giant robot. Now here's the deal. Here's the difference between spirit and ego. When you're in that body, a big giant robot body, and you so get how it works. You're an expert on how this motherfucker works. And you can just sit here, get in, and start driving. You got your monitors, you got your sensors, you can hear things, see things, feel things. You've got seismic stuff and it's perceived and you just really perceive. You got sense of smell, you can smell the ozone, the gunpowder, the wet mud, the tar, the sulfur swamp over there, and you can smell the bad guy coming like a fucking like a bloodhound, man. You've got sensory perception up the gazoo in your robot Metal Gear thing. You're good. Now, the only thinking you need to do is really so light, it's your decision making. If you're an expert at this game of war or this game of life in your body that you're controlling mechanically with software, wetware, hardware, then the thinking that you are doing is on a very fine level of decisional, intentional, inspirational. It's inspired. It's like, and you move. And the game of life gets really fun, and you're doing what you do, and you're, it's like being the best of the best, and you're playing that game you play. You don't go, Okay, so here's the difference between that, being the master in the game of life, and what most of us are as ego, playing it from the ego self. Imagine you coming into this fucking machine, and you're going, what's that? Where's the monitor where I turn on that shit? Oh, okay, I got that one. But where's that 3D hologram? I got this, where's the switch where I turn on the fucking pineal gland and open up the brow chakra so I can fucking see clearly? Where's that switch? I don't see it. Let me read a book. You get up the fucking manual and you're thinking and you're confused. You're in a fucking body and you gotta start thinking about it because you don't know. You're not in that place of knowing. And you're attention for playing that game out there, that game of life, playing in the war if it's the Metal Gear, and you're not the fucking expert. You're getting beat up and you go, what am I doing wrong? What am I even doing in this fucking box? This is a bitch, and you're getting blown up and hit and you're falling over and how do I stand this bitch back up? And think. And ow, that hurt. Can I get out of this bitch? No. And you're banging on the wall, let me out of here. And you can't get out. Spirit is so engaged and consumed in surviving in this thing that they don't understand how it works, that they have to think. And what they're really trying to do, what spirit is trying to do, is know how things work. Know it, get it, And so they can get on with the fun stuff of engaging in the perception devices. You put on the earphones, you put on the goggles, or you turn on your monitors, the audio, you got everything going for you, right? And you're out and you're playing the game again. You know, you're in your little robot body and you're just having a blast. Except for the part where if you don't know how the machine works and you actually start thinking you're the machine, so you get so messed up in your head, a lot of thinking, a lot of negative feelings, because it hurts, you want out, you don't get it, it doesn't make sense. So we have to think. So spirit becomes, instead of the perceiver and the knower, the thinker and the survivor. And so then the spirit that becomes, identifies with the body, or, and some of us, we don't identify as the body, but we identify ourselves as that individual in that thing, but our attention is engaged on the inside of the machine. It's like, where's that switch? Where's that thing where I can turn? Is there a thing in here where I can turn off pain? You know, like Data, Star Trek. He's got his emotion chip. He can turn it on and off. And we're looking for that fucking switch. You know, we're not looking out the monitor, out the eyeballs. We're looking inward in our control room. Like, is there a switch? I thought that was a button. And why is this thing working on automatic? How can I get it on manual? Because I want to take some more control over this fucker. And you, where is that manual switch? Did I miss the class? Where's the manual? You know, and so we engage in thinking as we experience our life in our physical bodies. And it's the very process of engaging in the thinking, or being, finding ourselves in a condition in spirit where thinking is necessary, or we believe it's necessary. That is what is really going on. It's not that we have an ego. We have a reference point, or a point from which we experience and live within a universe, a plane of existence. Right now we're in the physical plane of existence. Now, let's say that you really understood your Metal Gear Solid robot thing. You know, you get, and you know, oh, there's this, you got 7 switches for each of your chakras. Turn the ball on. Oh, and there's a little thing, a little warning. Do not turn on the root chakra first, full blast, without first clearing, blowing out the tubes on the other ones. You'll fuck something up. Oh, glad I read that. Some other guy didn't read it. Fucked up. But okay, you flip, and you got these fine tuning. You know what, in real life, we're doing our chakra meditations, and we're doing all this stuff to do it right and get it right, you know. But in our analogy, you're in your fucking machine and you're flipping these switches and you're opening up these chakras, and some of them are too big and some of them aren't big enough and some got fucking hair balls in them. What the fuck did that come from? And you go, and you're trying to get all this stuff working, right? And you go, right? Okay, so the reference point, the decisional perceiver that you are within a body of any kind is either too much engaged in how to deal with the thing that they have to think about. They lose the knowing and they move into the thinking about. The thinking about is a tool for knowing. We're supposed to think. Ah, I got it. That's the proper use of thinking. And the mind is just a system, a bunch of programming and beliefs and desires, and there's all this stuff, programming, like computer programming, that a lot of it is on automatic, and you can rewrite the program, but it's kind of hard if you don't know how it's all programmed. But it all is thinking. You are not that thinking. You are not that mind. But when spirit assumes a reference point, and a spirit has to, consciousness has to assume a point of reference, to communicate to other spirits who have also assumed points of reference. See? Because if you don't have a point of reference, you can communicate, but it's going to be telepathic. And then you're not really playing the game with your buddies unless everybody's on this higher level and you're playing a game telepathically. But even in a higher plane of existence, like say you're, you know, fourth to fifth density world and everybody's telepathic, isn't that neat? Oh yeah. But guess what? Everybody, that means a bunch of different people. They all are assuming a reference point, a point from which to communicate to others. So it's about reference point or viewpoint. It's not about ego. What an ego should be, or should be defined as, is the reference point. Now, depending on the density of reality you're in, let's say you're in third density, we are so caught up in our reference point, our point from which to view, and we do not understand the machine. We don't get the vehicle. We're so caught up in the thinking about life and how it works and what's the problem and why am I getting fucked every day and why am I happy today and sad tomorrow? Why can't I eat ice cream and feel good all the time instead of just wanting to eat ice cream? Why? Think. We shift out of knowing. We're in this reference point and we perceive ourselves as the person with the problem or the question and looking for the answers, and all this surrounds our point of reference. Okay. When we move into higher densities, lighter, higher densities, the amount of thinking is way, way less. Okay. So but you still have the reference point. So if it was ego, you still have an ego. And that's why I don't like the word ego, because ego is like it's something you're supposed to get the fuck rid of. But you cannot live in an experience with other individual beings without this point of reference. And it's simply the point of reference is more into perceiving, looking outward, and knowing. Look and know, look and know. That's essence, that's consciousness, that's looking and knowing. But even then, there's a little bit of decisional thinking going on. So it's a different level of thinking, but as the thinking gets more, the attention stops being drawn away from the external world and the joy of living life and experiencing it, smelling it, touching it, having fun, messing with the girls, messing with the guys, we're just laughing and having a great time, we're working, we're making neat things. It's all out. To the degree that your attention goes in and you start thinking about, why do I feel this way? What's wrong? How do I get out of here? Think, instead of knowing, think, then that is the reference point that we call ego. But it's just the same reference point. So you can't get rid, my argument here, and I could have said this in the first 2 minutes and the video would have been over. Okay? The reference point is that point is consciousness choosing a point from which to view and experience the world, the universe that consciousness finds itself in, whether it's a dream world, lucid dream world, out of body world, third, fourth, fifth density or higher or lower, it doesn't matter. It's a point from which to view and experience your life. Now, to the degree that spirit is looking outward, to that degree they're conscious. To the degree that they are outward looking, not thinking, knowing. And there's levels of knowing, and it gets wider and expansive, more and more expansive. There's more to know, and to the ultimate point of not, I'm never going to know at all. I don't know. But the point is, consciousness can expand outward. But consciousness can also turn inward, and we call that thinking. And it stops being on the external world that the reference point it finds itself in and goes into the internal thinking about that out there. Mental, physical, mental, outward, inward. You see the difference? But even if you're outward, you've got that reference point. So it's about a reference point or a point from which to view and experience life is the deal. Because you can't look outside and like completely lose the reference point. By definition, that's going around on the internet, you can certainly lose the ego because your attention is all outward. There is no ego. There is no self. Right. And you become the environment when that happens. And the environment is the reference point. And you say, I am now the environment. But you don't think it. You experience it. And as long as the attention is out there, attention is out there and the consciousness is on it and you experience it and you feel it. You have become the environment. And that's the reference point that is existing. And you can just keep taking it further and further, and the reference point becomes the all that is. But as the reference point gets smaller and smaller, and you start thinking, if you just start thinking, the idea of who you believe you are or think you are becomes the reference point. And when it looks like that, the label becomes ego. But I'm just trying to help myself and you guys as I talk about this. I'm getting my own clarity on this thing. I think that the idea of the word ego is a setup. And I think we're all dealing with it quite well as we try to deal with what an ego is. But trying to get rid of an ego is fine in certain ways if you define ego certain ways, but you do not get rid of that reference point. It just, the reference point changes. More out or more in. And anything else? It's a big subject. It's something to know, but it's okay to think about. Okay, and that, I guess that's a good place to wrap it up. Look over here. My wife's off camera here. We're sort of sharing with her too. So the point, I guess, another point I'm trying to make is that ego is not a bad thing. You don't get rid of the ego. It's technically, from my understanding of it, it's technically impossible for any teacher or anyone to be here now and communicate to another verbally without a little bit of ego there. There's got to be something there. There's a reference point there. Now, they may be speaking from a very high level of knowing, and they're not engaging in the gross mind, but they have some mind there. So that point from which they are viewing is always there. Now, when they think more, see, when you call it an ego and you got to get rid of the motherfucker, that's going to confuse a lot of people. Because I think a lot of people are smarter than that. They go, they say some of the teachings will tell you that that if you're thinking, that's the ego, that's not you. And if you get rid of who you think you are, then you're good. Well, a lot of people are going, wait, I don't want to get rid of me. Yeah, and you don't. See, what all you do is you just let go or refocus attention outward more and more and less inward. The less you are engaged in the thinking process, the more you engage in the perception process, perceive and know, without triggering the thinking about what you perceive, then you become more here now. And it's like by default, the thinking aspect of yourself isn't thinking. So that's ego being gone. The ego's mind gone. It's a process. It's an activity that you in spirit engage upon is the ego-ness of it all. So it's not like you get rid of who you think you are, you get rid of the ego, you don't, no. You can just refocus The more out, the more you are here now, conscious and knowing, as opposed to in here now, engaged in thinking, in an effort to know. So there's nothing wrong with being inside, looking inward, thinking about things, problems, chewing things over. It's an effort to know. It's part of your process, my process, everyone's process, to be here now and know. So it's all good. Okay. So with that said, I am out of here. Okay. Your questions and comments are certainly appreciated. Enjoy the feedback. And y'all take it easy, okay? Be nice. Thank you. Bye now.